The trumpets played and the angels sang every sweet refrain of amazing grace, and that heaven's hands opened up the gate and the children danced when they saw your face. As happy as they were to see you coming, I was just as sad to have to watch you go. Oh, but knowing what I know about heaven, believing that you're all the way home, knowing that you're somewhere better is all I need to let you go. I could hope that I could pray you back, but why on earth would I do that when you're somewhere life and love never ends? Oh, knowing what I know about heaven.
The title of the message wasn't on the flyer this morning. Hopefully you got to see the flyer. I've hung it up as quick as I could get it here, which I think it was Wednesday afternoon. I got off work, praise God. We always try to hang a flyer when we're going to be here. Today's the 4th, hallelujah. We'll be back the 18th, Sunday after next. We'll have a Sunday split, which will be 11th, and then we'll be right back here again, Lord tarries, on the 18th at 10 a.m., praise God. So come expecting. Come expecting, praise God, hallelujah. Have your Bibles this morning. Turn to the book of Luke. Luke. Book of St. Luke. I had two messages on my heart this morning. People worry about getting a message. I've never had to worry about getting a message since I've been called to preach. Glory to God. Ain't got nothing to do with me, Wilma. It all has to do with Him. Praise God. All I do is ask and He gives. Praise God. He knows I'll preach what He tells me to preach, whether it's good or whether it's hard, I'll still preach it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Got a little bit of reading to read this morning, but just bear with me, and I'll get just to the point just as fast as He allows me to get to it. Praise God. I'd like to title the message this morning. I'd like to title it Standing on Faith. Standing on Faith. Praise God.
What chapter you say?
Luke chapter 12. I'm sorry. Luke chapter 12, beginning at verse 41. Luke chapter 12, beginning at verse 41. Luke chapter 12, beginning at verse 41. It says, then Peter said unto him, Lord, speakest thou this parable unto us, or even to all? In other words, he means to all people. Verse 42, he says, and the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward, whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household to give them portion of meat in due season? He said, blessed is that servant, whom his Lord, when he cometh, shall find him so doing. Of a truth I say unto you, that he will make him ruler over all that he hath. But if the servant say in my heart, a lot of people are doing this right now, my Lord delayeth his coming, and shall begin to beat his men servants and maidens, eat and drink and be drunken. 46. So the Lord of that servant will come in a day when he looketh not for him, and in an hour when he is not aware, and will cut him asunder, and will appoint his portion with the unbelievers. Where's that at? In hell. Verse 47. And that servant which knew his Lord's will, and prepared not himself, neither did according to his will, shall be beaten with many stripes. Verse 48. But now he that knew not, and did commit things worthy of stripes, shall be beaten with few stripes. For unto whomsoever much is given, of him shall be much required. And to whom men have committed much of him, they will ask the more. verse 49, and the last verse I need to read. I am come to send fire on the earth, and what will I if it be already kindled? And turn your Bibles back to the book of Hebrews. I want to read just one verse. Book of Hebrews, right before James. That helps you in it. Hebrews chapter 11. You don't even have to turn up if you don't want to. But I want to read two verses. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, but it's the evidence of things not seen. And I want to read verse 11, chapter 11, verse 6 of Hebrews. Listen to this very carefully. You don't hear one more thing that I say this morning. Hear this verse and take heed to it. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Hallelujah. Without fear, praise God. Without anything in front of you, you've got to seek God's face. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to stand on faith this morning. We go back to Luke, praise God. Luke chapter 12, hallelujah. When I begin to read in verse 41, Peter asking Jesus to tell him this parable at his time of coming and when he would come. If you read this whole chapter, Peter is trying to get out of Jesus exactly the day that he's going to come back. Praise God, we all know in the Word of God that nobody knows the day or the hour except the Father. Hallelujah. But he said you would know by the signs. He said, by the signs I'll show you when I will come. Praise God. If you look today, many, many signs are pointing to his coming. Hallelujah. His coming back after who? His saints. Glory to God. The people that are born again, bought by the blood of Jesus that he shed on the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. But we've got to stand on faith. No matter what happens to us, no matter what we must go through, God spoke to me this morning, we've got to stand. Hallelujah. We've got to stand on God's word. I don't mean lay the Bible down. I've seen preachers do this, and I totally disagree with it. They'll lay the Bible down on the floor and stand on it with their feet. I do not believe in that whatsoever. But I believe you ought to carry it proudly. Hallelujah. And you ought to let people know that you're proud to be a Christian. Glory to God. It doesn't matter if you're on the mountain or you're in the valley. Hallelujah. You ought to be blessed and highly favored of God. Glory to God. No matter what's going on, my brother, you should still be blessed. Hallelujah. Why? Because God said his seed will never beg for bread. Hallelujah. He said, seek the kingdom first, and everything else shall be added unto you. Glory to God. If you stand on faith. Amen. If you stand on faith.
Right.
You've got to stand on faith. Praise God. You can't stand on anything else coming today. And your family will fail you. As much as the closest your family is, they'll still fail you. You know why? Because they're human.
Yeah.
They're human.
Yeah.
Sometimes things come up. You know, well, I can't make it. I'm going to have to go do this. Or I'm going to have to go do this. Or I can't go. I've got to work. Or I can't do this. I've got to do this. You can always stand on God.
Yeah.
God never fails.
Amen.
God never fails. You hear me this morning? God never fails. He said, I'll give you the desires of your heart. Praise God. But he said, you first must seek me. Seek me first. He's a jealous God. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, you know people today, they get up in the morning, they'll be cutting their grass, or they'll be polishing on their new trucks, or they'll be washing down their brand new homes, and that's their God. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know, Jesus said it's his will that we should prosper, but he has to be first this morning.
Right.
Glory
right.
to God. If we're going to stand on him, he has to be number one. Glory to God. No matter what happens, hallelujah, Jesus will always reign. Glory to God. No matter who goes in the office as president, whether it be a woman, man, or child, God is still in full control. Hallelujah. As long as we stand on faith. He says in his Bible, when I return, will I find faith? I just read it to you. He said, when I return, will I find you so doing this? Will I find you practicing what we're doing right now this morning? Practicing on the Sabbath day. Practicing being Christians. Glory to God. You see, a Christian is Christ-like. Hallelujah. We're supposed to be Christ-like. Sometimes when you look in the mirror, we don't see Christ. Come on now, preacher.
Sometimes we look in the mirror, we get so down. Hallelujah, you know. And to use this as a mirror sometimes. I've even brought a mirror one time down the street. And I ask everybody when they sit down, I said, before you leave tonight, look into this mirror and I want you to tell me who you see. Had a young boy walk up and he said, preacher, I just see myself. I said, you need to pray. Why? I said, because you need to see Jesus. You need to see Jesus. Praise God. What are you talking about, preacher? We ought to be able, hallelujah, we ought to be the most blessed people on the face of this earth right now. Glory to God. Why, preacher? I've got people passing in my family. I got people losing jobs and this and that and the other. But we ought to still be blessed and highly favored of God because God is still supplying our needs. None of us is going hungry. Hallelujah. I've never seen nobody go hungry or the righteous begging for bread. Hallelujah. As long as you keep your eyes on Jesus.
That's right.
You notice when Peter walked on the water, he walked fine until he looked away and took away from Jesus and he began to sink. Glory to God. But what happened when he began to sink? He cried out to a living God and Jesus reached down and grabbed him and held him back up. Come on, Peter. I got you. It's my words. I've got you, Peter. Walk beside me. Hallelujah. If you just follow after me, Peter, everything will be all right. He even asked Peter in the book of Mark chapter 6, Peter, who do the people say that I am? Right now today, everybody knows the word Jesus. Everybody. Even the atheist. You can talk. I've got a brother-in-law who's an atheist. He don't believe in God at all. Praise God. Hallelujah. I don't understand that because he's seen miracles right before him many, many times. Hallelujah. But he still don't believe in a living God. Hallelujah. He will one day. One day he will because he'll stand before him. And if he don't get saved, that same God that he don't believe in is going to cast him into hell. Hallelujah. Then he'll believe that day. Praise God. Only problem is it'll be too late. You hear me today? Hallelujah. We've got to stand on him. We've got to stand on him no matter what happens. I'm warning you today. There's a lot more coming. Hallelujah. There's a lot worse things coming than what's going on right now today. We're going to see things wax worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. Hallelujah. It's going to be up to you. Up to you as an individual if you're going to stand for Jesus or not. I can pray for you. You can call me anytime, day or night. You ask Johnny or Alan, I always tell them, if you ever need anything, call me day or night. I'm your shepherd, and I'll call you back as quick as I can. If I don't answer the phone, I'll pray with you in the middle of the night. It doesn't matter. I'll do anything I can for you to help you make it to heaven. But it's up to you, hallelujah, to make that decision to stand on faith. You got to believe who he is and what he is and why he came. Glory to God. You got to stand on faith.
Yeah.
No matter what happens. No matter what happens, we've got to stand on faith. Yeah. I stood when I walked into the funeral home. I prayed hard because when my mother died, I believe half of me died with her. Praise God. I'm still in deep, deep mourning, but I still hear the Father saying, what better one to take care of her than I? Hallelujah. But I said, but Lord, my heart is broke. He said, it will continue to be broke until it's joined together again. He said, but fret not. Oh, you hear me this morning? Fret not. Keep your eyes upon me and you'll see her again. Glory to God. See, I got that promise. And that's what I'm standing on this morning. Hallelujah. I know if I keep my eyes on Jesus and I do not waver, I'll see my mama and my daddy again one day and have church with them again. But I'll have church with them forever. You hear me this morning? If you got loved ones that's already went on before you and they were saved and born again believers, that ought to make you want to serve God with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul. Because you have that promise. You have that promise that says right here in the Word of God that you're going to receive them right into yourself. Praise God. When you walk into the gates of that beautiful city, they'll be right there waiting on you. Just as they were. Brand new bodies. Brand new glorified bodies to be with you forever and ever and ever and ever if you stand on faith. You see, the problem is there's so many people right now walking away. We hit a hump or a bump in the road, Brother Johnny, and we just want to walk away. We just want to let go. We just want to let go and turn away and go back to our old things. You see, that's what the enemy wants. He's here to kill, steal, and destroy. He has no faith. He has no faith in anybody. He don't even have faith in himself. Hallelujah. Because he knows what he has read the end of the book. He knows what's getting ready to happen to him. You read the book of the back of Revelations. He knows what's going to happen to him. He's going to get his head crushed. And he's going to be bound for 1,000 years. And we're just going to stand there and laugh at him. Praise God. Because all the torment and all the trouble and all the trials we went through because of him. Because of him. Because of the enemy. Praise God. But you got to have faith. You got to have faith if you're going to make it. You got to have faith. It starts out as a little mustard seed. Praise God. When you first get saved, it's up to you how much you grow. It's not up to God. It's not up to Jesus. It's not up to the Holy Ghost. It's up to you as an individual. How much you read the Word. How much you go to church. How much you testify. How much you glorify. How much you magnify. Hallelujah. The living God. And that's how your faith grows. Praise God. That's why you ever see somebody, hallelujah, when they're going through something, they don't go over it. They don't go under it. They don't go around it. But they got to go through it. Praise God. But when you get through to the other side, you notice that you weren't alone. Hallelujah. Praise God. He had Jesus walking right beside you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Because you stood upon his word. Hallelujah. You stood upon the faith. Hallelujah. The living God. Glory. I feel that all over me. Hallelujah. Because you stood upon his word. His word says without faith, it's impossible. Impossible to serve him. You cannot serve a living God if you don't have no faith. Hallelujah. But you ever notice people, Wilma? You watch people. And I challenge you to watch people. Watch me if you want to. That's fine. Watch anybody that says that they're a Christian and says that they're a child of God. When they're going through something, you find out how much faith they really have. Hallelujah. You find out who they really are. Praise God. You find out if you rub them the wrong way, you find out just how much tolerance they have. Praise God. We've got guys at work right now. I got bets going on. Had a gentleman, he's trying to straighten up. I've been talking to him. Oh, Bobby's brother, Bobby Warner's brother Gary. He's got the most filthiest mouth in the world, praise God. About like what I had before I got saved. Hallelujah. And he said, Ty, I'm trying to quit cussing. I'm trying to straighten up. I said, Gary, you never will until you give your life to Jesus. You can't do it on your own. I'll show you. So he tells me that he's going to do it without God. He said, I'll show you I can do it without him. Well, yesterday in the lunchroom about noon, he just blowed up. And there it went, you know. And everybody laughed at him except me. Because I know I've tried to do it like that before. Without God, without faith. So I went over and talked to him in his department, kind of snuck over in there, you know. And I said, hey, Gary Bob. He said, don't tell me. I said, no, I'm not going to tell you. I'm just going to let you know this. I told you that you couldn't do it without God. I said, you didn't see me laughing at you. He said, no, Ty, you wasn't laughing. I said, I'm not going to laugh at you. I'm not going to tease you. I just want to let you know you need Jesus. You got to have Jesus. I said, if you take Jesus, you'll never want to cuss again. You'll never want to breathe a word like that again. I said, why? It's because his blood covers a multitude of sins, and it'll wash you clean. Okay, get out of here. Get out of here, he said. Get out of here. He didn't want to hear no more. But one day he'll wish he will. My prayer is he gets saved sooner because he's kind of like a leader there. Everybody kind of looks at him, praise God. And it'll be a domino effect. If he gets saved, other ones will get saved. It'll be a domino effect. And then maybe I'll be done over there. That's maybe why God has me still there. I don't know. Praise God. But I'm going to tell you something today. You've got to let your faith grow. Hallelujah. Continue to water it. How can you water it, preacher? Get in the Word of God. Hallelujah. Let it grow. Talk to God. And he'll talk to you. Praise God. Go to a house of praise. Hallelujah. And listen to the truth as it's preached. Hallelujah. And your faith will grow. You'll be able to walk better. You'll be able to talk better. Praise God. You'll be able to serve God with all your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you got to have all of this. It takes it all. From Genesis to Revelations. Praise God. Hallelujah. From Genesis to Revelations. Praise God. Stand on. No matter what. Oh, that's all right. You're fine. You don't bother me, bud. You gotta have faith. You gotta have faith. Hallelujah.
Can you imagine if they would come to your house, praise God, and take all your Bibles out of your house and all your spiritual pictures out of your house? I don't know about you all, but I try to hang as much spiritual things up in my house that I can. Why, preacher? Because it helps me. Glory to God. I got a revival sticker hanging over top of my French fry cutter out in the garage. And I got right in front of my workshop says, "Good morning, God. Hallelujah. I will need your help today. And he'll be taking care of all my problems." And uplifters. They're uplifters for you, praise God. It keeps your faith up here instead of down here, praise God. The more you get into this, the more you'll like it. It's hard to understand, preacher. Baloney. It's not hard to understand. You take your time. Read it verse upon verse. Chapter upon chapter. And it gets easier and easier as you read it. Praise God. I try to read it all the way through. From front to back every year. A whole year. I take a whole year to read the whole word. And then I do the same thing year after year. Year after year. Am I bragging? No. I just want a closer walk. Praise God. I want a closer walk. Do you hear this morning? We need to have a closer walk if we're going to stand on his faith. Because I'm going to tell you something. There's times you'll think you're going to be all alone. Hallelujah. There's times. Me, I walked out in the yard. I don't know how many times here lately after losing my mother. And I felt like I've been all alone. But then all of a sudden, Johnny, I felt a breeze blow. A breeze blow around me, Wilma, and I knew it was the presence of the Lord, hallelujah, to walk with me right there, and it kind of reminded me of the footprints in the sand, praise God, that when I was going through the trials, and I didn't see one footprint, but I seen two, glory to God, two sets, because God was carrying me, praise God, hallelujah. That's what he'll do if you stand on faith. He even tells us in the book of Matthew, he said, don't even worry about what you eat. Don't even worry about your clothing. He said, because I know that you have desire of all these. He'll take care of you if you let him. If you let him. But see, you got to sell out. You got to completely sell out. Sell out everything you've got. He's not talking about your worldly, the world things you got. He's talking about the things right here. Right here in your heart. Sell out to him. Because everything else won't mean nothing to you. They're just material things. I always say all the time, if I don't care if I lose all my material things, as long as I don't lose my soul. Because I'm going to tell you something. For what shall profit a man to gain this whole world? And I'm almost finished. To gain this whole world, but lose his soul. You see, sometimes we get way up here on a mountaintop, and God has to bring us down a little bit. Has to cut us down just a little bit. You know why? Because we don't tend to use him as much when we're up on a mountaintop. You ever notice that? You don't praise him as much. Hallelujah. When you got plenty of money in your pocket, plenty of food, and the refrigerator's plumb full, and everything's going right, you don't praise him as much. But let everything fall apart. Come on now, preacher. Let everything fall apart. Let the cupboard start to get bare. Let the bills back up. Let everything go on. And then you, oh my Lord, where you at, God? Oh Lord, where you at? He knows this. He knows it because we're human. We're human, praise God. He knows this is going to happen. But ain't you thankful this morning for mercy and grace? Amen. That you can go to the living God. No matter where you're at, Alan. Father, forgive me. Forgive me of what I've acted, for what I've done, for what I've been through, how I've treated you, Lord, when I was up on that mountaintop. Because now I'm in the valley, and I need to be lifted up, Lord. And you know what? The Bible says, if you do that with a contrite spirit and a sorrowful heart, he is just to forgive you. How many times, Peter said, Lord? How many times? Seven? He said, no, Peter. Seven times 70. Hallelujah. In other words, he'll just keep forgiving you. That's not a license to sin, but that's mercy and grace. Praise God. Right now, what we're living under, mercy and grace. Praise God.
Yep.
But you got to stand on faith. Can you see Jesus? You got to be able to look in the mirror and see him. Now you can't see his face. No one has seen his face. Hallelujah. No one has, praise God. But we will one day. If we keep walking on faith, keep standing on faith, praise God,
and keep listening to the truth. Because the truth's going to set you free. If I just tickle your ear all the time and saying what you're doing is okay, just keep on sinning. I'll use Alvin as an example. Don't mean anything by it. Just keep on sinning and just keep on doing what you're doing. You're okay. You'll be all right. I'll rock you right to sleep and you'll find yourself in hell. Yeah. But if I preach to you what he gives to me, to let you know that there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun, you'll make it. You won't make it. Not thanks to me, but thanks to him. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, all I am is a mouthpiece. All I'm doing is exhorting. All I want to do is lay up crowns in glory. That way I don't walk in empty-handed. I want to walk in weighted down with crowns so I can usher him at his feet and praise him for the next 10,000 years, forever and ever and ever. I don't want to just slide in. Somebody over at work yesterday said, if I just get in by the skin of my teeth, I'll be all right. But you're not going to make it. You're not going to make it that way. The Bible says that the righteous scarcely make it in. Where does it lead? The sinner and the ungodly. It leads them in hell. Everyone that cries, Lord, Lord, is not going to make it in. You got to have a relationship with him. And I'm finishing right now. You got to have a relationship with him. It takes faith. It takes faith. Let it start out as a mustard seed and let it grow. Keep loving on him. Praise him every chance you get. Get in your own apartment or get in your house or wherever you live in. I don't care if you live in a cardboard box. Praise him. Just praise him. There's nothing wrong with raising your hands up and glorifying God. If you notice, I've been opening up every street meeting, starting out, your hands in the air, glorifying God. He's worthy, church. He's worthy. Take a look at your life, and you know he's very worthy. I'm an old drug addict, saved by grace. Hallelujah. I got saved. Hallelujah. A little country church. Hooked on dope. Hooked on pills. Hooked bad. But Wellman, he seen something in me that he could use. And when I knelt down and prayed, chains fell off of me. The bondage fell off of me. 15 years here in about 3 more weeks. 15 years, praise God, hallelujah, I've been saved. Not one time went back and smoked the dope. Not one time went back and done the pills, praise God. I don't need them no more. I've got Jesus, praise God, and I'm standing on that. I'm standing on that faith, hallelujah, that he's going to keep me. Hallelujah, no matter what happens, no matter if anything goes on in the world, I'm going to be able to carry my sword with me, hallelujah, and put on the helmet of salvation, glory to God, and shred my feet with the righteousness of God, and be able to walk upright before the living God. Put on the full armor, the breastplate. Put on the full armor of God. Have my feet shod with the word of God. And put on the full armor of God, like it says in Ephesians chapter 6. Praise God, and you'll make it. You'll make it. You know who our worst enemy is? Our worst enemy is our own people that sits right beside us. That's some of our worst enemies. Because they see us do something, oh, look at you. You ain't no more Christian than that Russian tank driver. Instead of laying hands on you and praying for you and loving on you and letting you know that it's going to get better, we crucify our own flesh. We crucify our own people in our own church. Come on, preacher. Yeah. Hallelujah. We're the hardest ones on each other. It's our own church. Yeah. We need to get out of that. We need to turn away from that and begin to love on each other and unify. Unify with each other. Ask that brother if you see him going through something. Hey, you need prayer? Let's pray. No matter if you're in Walmart or wherever you're at, lay hands on them. Put your hand on their shoulder. Say, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, help my brother today. Help my brother today. Because you might be that brother that needs prayer next. Or that sister that needs prayer next. Praise God. You hear me this morning? Praise God. If you didn't hear one thing that I preached this morning, hear this. Jesus is coming. And he better find faith in you when he comes. You better find you watching, prayed up, and waiting for his return. Praise God. If not, you're not going to make it. You're not going to make it. Hallelujah. I'm not going to make it if I don't do the same exact thing as you all do. I'm not exempt from it. Just because I'm a called man, Holy Ghost filled man of God, I'm not exempt from it. Matter of fact, I'm held in a higher responsibility. Praise God. Everything I preach to you, everything I tell you, it's on my hands if it's not the truth. If I'm not speaking the truth today, the blood will be on my hands. Your souls will be on my hands, and that's not going to happen. Praise God. That's not going to happen. If I didn't hear it from the throne room, I'm not going to preach it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can you give him a hand clap of praise this morning? He's worthy. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I keep staring at this, and I might as well read it. It's right on the front of my Bible. Very familiar verse. Jeremiah 29:11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." Praise God. Hear me this morning. Jesus can take care of you. He can hold on to you when nobody else can. Hallelujah. I love my wife more than anything in the world. I'd give my life for her. My brother, I feel the same way. I'd give my life for him. And when it comes to Jesus, he's my Jesus. He's my number one. No matter what my family does, no matter what my friends does, I've got to follow Jesus. I have to. I've got to get there. I got a mommy and I got a daddy. I got aunts and uncles, praise God. I got Brother Bill Riley, used to sit right here and pound his chest and taught me how to walk by faith. I got all of them. Sister Opal Mick, praise God. Uncle Carl, hallelujah. I've got many people that I've got to go see, let alone see the face of Jesus. Hallelujah this morning. Follow him with all your heart and all your soul. I don't preach another message. Remember, follow Jesus with all you got. With all you got. Is it easy? Not all the time. I'd be a liar to tell you if it was easy. It's not easy all the time. It's not a bold church, just like Brother Randy said in his testimony. But you know what? He'll help you. If you read this, talk to him, pray to him. Hallelujah. You don't even have to go to that 900 people church, will you? Praise God. Hallelujah. As long as you have a relationship with Jesus. I don't care if you go to a church with one person in it. As long as it's Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Anybody need prayer this morning? Anybody need an anointed cloth? Anybody need anointed at all? Anybody need any prayer or anything before we close the service this morning? Anybody have any comments or anything? Anybody? All hearts clear? All hearts clear? Brother Andy, if you will, stand and dismiss us this morning.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this morning, dear God. We thank you for the freedom of worship,
yes,
dear Heavenly Father. We thank you we can come into a place and they use it for your community service any other time, community center.
Lord.
But we can use it as a church, dear God.
Yes,
Lord. And one thing and one thing only, to worship you.
Yes, Lord.
To tell you how much we love you and how much we appreciate what you've done for us.
Hallelujah.
We just thank you for walking beside us today, dear Heavenly Father. Let us go out of this place and tell one person about you, dear
Hallelujah.
God.
Hallelujah.
And we pray they'll bow a knee and take you into their heart, dear Heavenly Father. Let them go talk to somebody.
Yes.
Let that domino effect, as my brother talked about, happen,
yes,
dear God, in this town of Portsmouth.
Yes,
the
Father.
Surrounding areas, dear Heavenly Father. We know you're everywhere, dear God.
Yes.
We just thank you and we praise you this morning, dear Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen, amen. If the weather holds out, this Saturday, the 10th of October, we'll be back at Tracy Park for the last meeting of the year. Hallelujah. Let it just be a wall bash. Praise God. Just let the power of the Holy Ghost fall. Pray for good weather. I want to set up one more time. Hallelujah. And just preach the gospel out on the street. One more time. Hallelujah. Before this year is up. So pray for good weather. If not, we'll be back here anyway. If the Lord tarries, the 18th. I'll have a flyer up. Cindy prints it up. I'll have a flyer up. Somebody can have that one if they want it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Mom always did keep them, so anybody else want them? Do you want it, Wilma?
Yeah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Mom probably had, I hate to tell you how many she had up there in her apartment. When we cleaned her apartment out, she had a thick on my map, that thick.
Praise God. She kept them all. Proud of them. Praise God. Hallelujah. But remember the service here the 18th at 10 a.m. October the 18th at 10 a.m. Hallelujah. Like I said, pray for your preacher. Praise God. I need all the prayer I can get. Praise God. I'm walking through one of them forests right now, getting poked with a lot of thorns. Glory to God. Am I backslidden? No, no, no. Hallelujah. Am I sinning? No, no, no. Just going through one of them valleys right now. Hallelujah. But I'm still blessed and highly favored of God. Hallelujah. I'm going to make it. I have to make it. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you all.